Okay, looks like we're live. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. Hope you're having a wonderful day today. If you don't know me, if you're not familiar with me, my name is Ryan McCrary. I'm the CEO, Chief Executive Officer, and founder, HNIC, of McCrary Financial Solutions, where we provide financial solutions through entrepreneurship, financial literacy, and digital marketing training. Do me a favor, just jump on, type your name, where you're from, and if you have a business, type the name of your business. If you watch this on replay, do me a favor, type replay down in the comments, and your name, where you're from, and what your business is. Today we'll be talking about business, entrepreneurship, how to increase sales, how to make more money. Who wants to make more money? If you want to make more money, drop a comment down in the chat. If you want to make more money, if you don't want to make more money, that's fine. I can hop off. I can go about my day. I can go about trying to make myself more money, but it's not just about me. I like to give back. I like to provide resources, expertise, stuff that I learned. A lot of things I've learned the hard way. A lot of things, you know, I didn't have anyone specifically telling me things. A lot of things I had to learn through trial and error. So me, my job is to make it easier for you. Jason, how you doing? King, good senior at the ABNC. So shout out to the ABNC. Shout out to Dr. Watkins and his whole camp, Michelle and everybody. That's my fam, so shout out to everybody. Also, everyone, do me a favor, please share. Please share, this is an important conversation, brief conversation that we're gonna have today about business, entrepreneurship, how to make more money. My goal is for our community and entrepreneurs, everybody in the entrepreneurship life, to make more money. Who wants to make more money? Like I said, if you don't wanna make more money, that's fine. I can get off here. I don't have to share nuggets. I don't have to share jewels. But for the people that do want to make more money, let me know. Drop a comment in. Drop a question in. About to be a fucking accident already. People just getting out of school, about to be an accident. Play Ecology, high quality and inexpensive STEM toys for our little one. That is excellent. That is great. I'd love to interview you if you would like. If you would like me to interview you on your business, email customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com. That's customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com. If you would like me to interview you about your business, any other business owner, you have to be a real business owner. I can't put anybody in front of my audience on my platform who is not legit. But if you are legit, please email customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com. customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com, and just tell me your business, the name of your business, where you're from, how long you've been in business, so forth, and I would love to interview you and love to get you, you know, on my platform, try to get you more sales, whatever the case may be. Desiree, how you doing? No business yet from Arkansas. Great. Shout out to Arkansas. I send a lot of books to Arkansas. Send a lot of books to the South, West Coast, London, Hawaii, New York, ATL, Detroit, Philly, everywhere. Desiree, would you like to be a business owner? That is the next question. If you're not a business owner, that's fine. Would you like to be a business owner? Who is currently not a business owner, but would like to be a business owner? If that's you, drop a like, drop a heart, drop a comment in, and let me know, because I can definitely help you with becoming a business owner, because I think we need more business owners out here. We need a lot more business owners, especially Black business owners. We need a lot more of them. So if that is you, drop a comment, drop a like in. Also, please share. Again, before I give you the five ways on how to make more money in your business, if you watch this on replay, type replay down, drop a question, drop a comment in. Just so we know we watched it, type replay down. Also, if you just jump on, type your name. Sun is bright. Type your name, where you're from, and the name of your business. If you have a business, early startup, no sales yet, that's fine. Nothing wrong with that. The main thing is when you're a startup, just having proof of concept. You know, when you're just starting out and you're brand new, you really want to get proof of concept. So you really want to just be going out, gathering data, gathering interest, gathering information. You know, like with my products and stuff, like if I'm starting a new product, I will not be hesitant to give it away for free. So if it's a new product or service, if I have the ability to do it, I have no problem giving it away for free. just to get people to see if they like it. So if it's a service, if I'm a coach, I would give a free consultation or, you know, give some free trainings just to see how people respond to it, just to get some feedback, just to get some information, just to get, you know, stories of how my product or service gave a result to someone else, how my product or service changed someone else's life. So once you have that, once you have that proof, once you have that story, once you can say, I went out and delivered a product or service to X, Y, and Z, and this is the result that person got, and then you have testimonials from those people about how your product and service helped them, even though you gave it to them for free initially, that is how you can blow the business, because you will give that story, sell that story, that testimonial of how you, your product and service helped that individual. Then you can give that to the masses of how your product or service helped them and why they need to buy your product or service. So, sorry, somebody sent me a message. Okay, so the five ways to make more money in your business. Five, tip number one is customer service. Customer service. I was on a conference call earlier this morning with my team, my I Buy Black team, and we were talking about customer service, especially for Black-owned businesses. How many of y'all have went into a Black-owned business that was not up to par? Probably all of us. But what you do not want to do is, if you go into a Black business, any business really, but especially Black business, and you have a bad experience, what you don't want to do is say, this is why I don't shop at Black-owned businesses. That is one of my pet peeves, because when you go into a different business and you don't have a good experience, what happens all the time, you don't say, I'm never shopping at a white business anymore. That never happens. So if you go to a Black business and it's not up to par, do not say, I'm never shopping at Black-owned businesses again. Just go to a different business. Just go to a different business and try to find a Black one. But we as African-American business owners, we do need to step up our customer service. We need to step up our customer service. All the amazing businesses that you see out here, Amazon, the whatever other, you know, amazing businesses, most of them have great customer service. I mean, Amazon is a company that has 500,000 employees, biggest company in the world, and you can still, you know, their customer service may not be, you know, A+, but you can still call and get someone on the phone. If you have a problem with your order, their customer service, their support responds very quickly. And that's an organization that is like, I don't even know the exact number, almost a $1 trillion company. But, you know, they you still can call them on the phone. You can get an email reply back. You know, you can get your package in a day. You know what I mean? So it's imperative for our businesses to focus on customer service. A lot of people, business owners, especially when you first start out, we don't think about that. We're only talking about sales, how to make more money, how to try to get in front of more people, how to network, stuff like that. But, you know, to make more money, you need to step up your customer experience. It shouldn't even be customer service. It should be customer experience. People should love shopping with your product or service. They should love shopping with your business, because then they start raving about you. Then they create videos and content around how great your service was, or your, you know, customer experience was, and that'll get them back into the store. That'll get them back into the product or service. That'll get them to give you referrals. You know, then you can start a referral program and an affiliate program, stuff like that. But it comes with customer service. So whether that's phone support, whether that's email support, there's things like Zendesk. There are other, you know, third-party platforms you can use to help you with your customer service as a business owner. But you need to be working on your customer service. If you have a restaurant and somebody comes into your restaurant, they need to be greeted at the door. They need to be greeted at the door. They need to be asked if they need anything. They need to know everything, all the information about your product or service. When someone, you know, buys from you, they need a follow-up email. They need a thank you email. They need all that type of stuff. If someone orders a product from you and you have to send it to them, you need to be giving them shipping information. If someone buys a book from me, they don't just buy a book and that's it. I send you the tracking number. I give you the confirmation. I give you the estimated delivery date. All that type of stuff. That is something that you need to be giving. Don't just sell a product and just send it out. You give them no tracking number. You give them no information. You give them no support line, nothing like that. We need, as Black business owners, it's imperative. We have to step up our customer service. Okay, Desiree, I want to own a beauty supply store. That is great. We need more black people in the industry because the Asians are taking over the industry. I heard something today in Philadelphia. There is an Asian-owned store. It's a barbershop. And they're cutting black people's hair. A barbershop. An Asian-owned barbershop cutting black people's hair, but they refuse to hire a black person. I just heard that today. It's crazy. I think it's on 52nd Street if you're in Philly. Asian-owned barbershop. It's bad enough that they're in the community taking over our market share of an industry that we have on lock, barbershops. That's bad enough that they're trying to take market share in the industry, but they won't even hire anybody from our community. They refuse to hire a black person. Yeah, that's definitely crazy. So, want to own a beauty supply store. I think that's great. I think you should definitely start with online. Start selling products online first. And then once you start selling online, once you have a customer base, once you have an email list, you know, once you have a Facebook page, an Instagram page, then you can go about getting your own store. You can get into Sally Beauty. You can get into, you know, the Targets or whatever case may be. I know a couple natural hair people or beauty supply people, they started online, whether it was private label products or their own products, started online before they went into stores, before they, you know, started having proposals to go into stores or start their own store, especially with online. Online just changed the way you can do business. So you can do business at a much cheaper rate as opposed to having a higher overhead, managing a store and all that type of stuff. So if you're just starting out, I would start online and I would just immerse myself in the industry. I would get around people who are in the industry. I would go to trade shows and conferences and anything, get a tribe or community of people in that industry. Get around people in that niche, in that industry, you know, and then just go from there, start reading and learning and all that type of stuff. But just get immersed in that industry. You know what I mean? Learn the business of beauty supplies and beauty stores, stuff like that. Because a lot of us, you know, we just want to, even like entertainment, people just want to be entertainers. They want to be rappers, whatever the case may be, but they don't learn the business side of it. You know what I mean? A lot of people want to be creatives and want to create great products or, you know, stuff to make people look good, but they don't learn the business behind it. They don't learn about the margins. They don't learn about, you know, products and fulfillment and just a lot of different things. So I would just say get immersed in the culture, in the industry. So tip number two to make more money in your business is to just increase your product line. A lot of people just sell that same product or service all the time. The same one product or service for the last 6 months, year, 2, 5, 10 years, you need to switch it up. And there's nothing wrong with that. If you're a service-based company, there's nothing wrong with creating a product around your service. Me, I'm service and product. So I offer a coaching service, a consulting service, you know, business consulting, financial consultant, all that type of stuff. But I also have products around my service. I have a book that is a product that's based around my service. So the book is not my entire business. I'm not trying to create a business off a $10, $20 book. The book is a product based around a service, which is a higher ticket value. It costs a lot more to get me one-on-one than to buy a free book and just pay the shipping. So always create different product lines. If you're product-based, you can be service-based. Like if I'm a product and I sell t-shirts, I can create a service and saying, I can help you build your t-shirt company. So I'm a t-shirt, I'm an e-commerce store, I sell products online. Now I can say, okay, I've been doing this for a couple years. I know it's a thing or two about creating t-shirts. Now I can provide a coaching service for other people that want to sell t-shirts or want to start an e-commerce store. That's just creating a service around a product and just creating multiple streams of income. So you as a business owner, another way you can potentially increase revenue for your business is just to increase your product line. Just put more things out. Put more different t-shirt designs out. Put different products around your niche. You know, try a service or try this, whatever the case may be, increase your product line. The third way you can increase sales in your business is just sell more products to the same people. A lot of people think to increase revenue for your business, you got to go out and keep getting new clients. Of course, you can go out and get new leads, get new clients. That's great. But you can also just sell more products to the same people. If you have an email list with 2,000 people and they regularly spend $500 a month on your product or service, try to sell them more products and service to that same 2,000 people to your email list. That's just another tip on how you could potentially increase more leads. Again, if you just joined in, my name is Ryan McCrary, the CEO of McCrary Financial Solutions, designed to give financial solutions through entrepreneurship, digital marketing, and financial literacy. Please share this if you haven't shared already. If you come on after, please type replay down your name, where you're from, and the name of your business, and your website. Keith, what's going on, bro? How you doing? How's everything going? So again, put your name, where you're from, and the name of your business, and your website. So tip number four on ways you can increase more money for your business. Start buying more ads. Start advertising more. Start getting more traffic. Start increasing your ad budget. You don't know how many business owners I talk to all the time and I say, all right, you want to get more money, you want to get in front of more people, what's your advertising and marketing budget? And they don't have one. If you're a business owner, you have to have an advertising and marketing budget if you want to build a real business, if you want to build a real corporation, not just a hustle, not just a mom and pop thing, you know, you do when you get off work. My bad, y'all, I had to take that call. All right, Keith says, good, bro. Thanks for asking. Almost done the book. Great, great. When you're done with the book, please write a review on Amazon if you could. Just go to Amazon.com and write a review if you can when you get done. Okay, so again, you don't know how many business owners I talk to, and I'm like, all right, so what's your marketing advertising budget? And they don't have one. It doesn't have to be a lot necessarily starting out. You know, it doesn't have to be thousands of dollars, $10,000, $20,000, $100,000 in the beginning. It doesn't have to. It could just be $20 a day on a Facebook ad. That adds up. You know, that'll get you in front of more people. That is a way you can collect data, but it has to be something. Like I said, if you want to build a real business, a corporation, not just a hustle, not just, you know, you selling t-shirts and you go, you know, out and, you know, try to hustle a couple t-shirts, or you try to put it on your Facebook personal page and you try to build it organically, that's not going to get you very far. If you want to really scale a company, you need to have a sound advertising and marketing budget. Like I said, it could be $20 a day on ads. It could be $100 a day on Facebook ads or Google ads or YouTube ads, or and they got Amazon ads now, or Twitter, or, you know, radio or TV, which I don't necessarily recommend. I would recommend Facebook ads, Instagram ads, just because they're underpriced currently. But you need to have some type of advertising marketing budget. A lot of people always say, look at Nike. Nike, you know, Nike's been around for 50, 60 years. They already have over 90% market share in the sneaker industry. Do they still spend money on ads? Do they still have a marketing budget? Yes, they do. You know what I mean? Like McDonald's, one of the largest companies in the world. You can't go anywhere, especially in our country, a couple miles without seeing a McDonald's, probably two within the same block. Do they spend money on marketing and ads? Yes, and it's the biggest company in the world, been around forever. Do they still spend money on marketing and advertising? Yes. So why would you think as a business owner now you have to spend no money on ads, you don't need a marketing budget? If that's the case, you should just go back and get a job. Don't become an entrepreneur. So again, you need to be spending money on ads, on marketing. It doesn't have to be Facebook. It doesn't have to be traditional, but it needs to be something. You need to be getting your product or service in front of people on a regular basis. My recommendation will be looking at Facebook or Instagram ads. You can create custom audiences. You can create lookalike audiences. You can create audiences based around your email list, based around how many people like your page. You can create audiences based around people who visited your website but didn't purchase, people who took some type of action online or offline. So there are many ways to target. There are many ways to, advertise or spend those dollars wisely. But you need to have some type of budget. And I would strongly suggest you start with Facebook. You can start small. Start with $10, $20 a day on ads and just see. $20 a day is going to get you in front of probably a couple thousand people a day, or maybe more. So, you know, that's something you just need to do. And then you can see how you can increase sales. You can get your pixel running. You can create upsells. You can create an email sequence behind when someone opts in. So there are many different ways to go about it, but just make sure you have a marketing budget. Tip number five that I'm going to let y'all go, you know, for the rest of your day is just follow up. Tim, what's up, King? The fortune is in the follow up. Again, fifth way to increase sales for your business is just to follow up. The fortune is in the follow up. Anybody who knows business will tell you the fortune is in the follow up. So what does that mean? That means if you have a brick and mortar store and someone comes in, but they're not ready to purchase, you make sure you get their name, their number, and their email to get them back into the store. You ever go to buy a car and car salesmen are trying to get you that day? What do I got to do to get you to purchase this car and drive the lot today? That's their main objective. But if you don't purchase that today, they get your name, they get your email when you fill out the form. Best believe they're going to be blowing up your phone. Best believe they're going to be blowing up your email box. Come back into the store. What else can I do? Can you get another 10% off? We have extra warranty. Oh, the car now has heated seats, all that type of stuff. They're going to keep following up with you. Phone calls, answer machine, emails, they're going to keep doing this. And after a while, a lot of people are going to be like, let me just go back in there. They added some, you know, amenities, they added some upgrades. It took X amount of dollars off. Let me just go back in there and just get that because I really wanted that car. I just really wasn't ready to purchase that day. I have to do better with following up, most definitely. That is the key to automation. That is why you want to look at automation and look at having a smart software, a CRM, a customer relationship management system. Because once you have automation, once you have a system, it will automatically follow up for you. As business owners, listen, we're busy. We got a million things. If we're juggling family and kids and all that, that's just a million things to juggle. Following up with clients usually falls to the bottom of the list. So that is why you want to have an automated system. If you want to talk about that offline, email me, email customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com. Customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com. And we can talk about that on, you know, how you can set the automation up, the system I use and other systems you can use. We can talk about that offline, but you want to make sure you have automation where we'll automatically follow up. So if someone opts in, someone purchases your product, someone browses your website, someone comes into your brick and mortar store, you can have processes in place that will automatically follow up with the client. Automatically, whether it's through fulfillment, you know, product fulfillment, you know, if someone books a call with you, you can have automated follow-up for them, you know, a week or a day before the call to make sure they're on the call. There are many different ways to go about it, but make sure you have automation. So again, the fifth tip is follow up. Make sure you follow up with your clients because the fortune is in the follow up. So that's it for today. Again, if you watch this on replay, type your name, where you're from, and what your business is, and your website. Any other questions, you can email you can send a message right to the page, right to the business page. You can send a message if you have any questions, or you can also email customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com. That's customerservice@mccraryfinancialsolutions.com. If you have not got my book yet, whatever rock you've been hiding under, whatever drugs you've been using, stop that and go to mindovermoneybook.com. That's mindovermoneybook.com. Everybody have a great day.